गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद अ वेरी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर द एक्सरसाइज सॉल्यूशन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 16। हियर यू कैन सी दैट सेकंड पीरियड के एलिमेंट की बात करते हैं, और तो सेकंड पीरियड इज द पर्टिकुलर एलिमेंट दैट स्टार्ट्स विद ग्रुप 1, ग्रुप 13 टू ग्रुप 18, दैट मींस ग्रुप 1, ग्रुप 2 सॉरी, ग्रुप 2 में है लिथियम, ग्रुप 2 बेरिलियम, देन ग्रुप 13 में बोरोन, कार्बन, ऑक्सीजन, नाइट्रोजन एंड फ्लोरीन एंड नियोन, ये सारे पीरियड सेकेंड के एलिमेंट्स। अब उसने ऐसा पूछा गया है कि व्हाई बी की बेरिलियम हैज हायर आयन एडिशन एंथैल्पी देन बोरोन। इसका आंसर है व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट द एस इलेक्ट्रॉन दिस आर वेरी नियर बाय टू द न्यूक्लियस मोर देन द पी इलेक्ट्रॉन। So, whenever we talk about the beryllium, electron which are removed from the particular orbital and the electron which are there in the s orbital during the ionization of boron, that is from p orbital, p electron. So, here when we talk about the p electron of boron, it is having more sending effect than that of the 2s orbital, and that's why we can say that beryllium has higher ionization enthalpy than boron. Next, oxygen has lower ion addition enthalpy than nitrogen and fluorine. So, here the oxygen ka jo bhi, when you have talked about the oxygen, electronic configuration of oxygen, nitrogen ki agar dekhe to we have 1s2, 2s2, px1, 2py1, 2pz1. That means we have how many electrons, when we talked about, it is 6 to become stable one. But whenever we talk about oxygen, oxygen does not become stable by this electronic configuration and fluorine also. So we can say that oxygen has lower ion addition enthalpy than that of nitrogen and fluorine. Now move to the next question, children. Here, that how would you explain the fact that the first ion addition enthalpy of sodium is lower than that of magnesium, but second ionization enthalpy is higher than that of magnesium. अब यहाँ पे बात करते हैं सोडियम की, तो उसके पास है नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन क्लियरली। Now it loses one electron and becomes stable like neon, so it becomes Na plus. That means the electron is there now removed from which orbital? 3s orbital. But when we talked about magnesium, magnesium itself does not lose two electron at same time. It loses the electrons one after another. So, when you come to the first ionization enthalpy of sodium, is lesser than magnesium. But when we talked about the second ionization enthalpy of sodium, it is more than that of magnesium because sodium ion is more stable than that of sodium atom. So, that is the reason that magnesium plus one does not have an extra stable configuration because at a time containing 11 electrons, when it remove one electron, then it becomes like non-stable. So we can say that here that second ionization enthalpy of sodium is more, whereas the first ionization enthalpy of sodium is lower than that of magnesium. Magnesium, uske do electron hai, wo directly loss karega nahi. It is going to be remove out the electron from its outermost shell as cell one by one. That means it has successive ionization enthalpy, and that is the reason where we can say that first ionization enthalpy of sodium is lesser, whereas the second ionization enthalpy of sodium is more than that of magnesium. Now question number 18, children, when we talk about which are the factors which affect the ionization enthalpy, so that is about the atomic size, sibling effect and nuclear charge. So force of attraction about the nucleus, that is we can say that about the nuclear charge, repulsion of the electron from each other, that means we can say that nuclear charge is going to affect the ionization enthalpy, as well the sibling or splitting effect of the valence, last electron from the nucleus by entering core electrons, jo bahari ke electron hai उनके ऊपर सेंडिंग इफेक्ट, इट इज गोइंग टू बी इंक्रीज व्हेन यू आर द न्यूक्लियर चार्ज इज गोइंग टू बी इंक्रीज, तो ये इट रिक्वायर्स लेस एनर्जी व्हेन यू आर मूविंग डाउन द ग्रुप, सो ये रीजन है कि आयनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी is there based on atomic size, nuclear charge and Sylvian effect. Either if you don't want to write this, you can write the answer like that atomic size as well the nuclear charge as well the Sylvian or Sylvian effect, they are going to affect the ionization and that is when we are moving down the group. Now, question number 19 when we talked about, here the value is given here first ionization enthalpy in the unit of kilojoule per mole. And all the elements are of group 13 elements, that means boron, aluminium, gallium, indium, thallium. Now here aluminium has lower ionization enthalpy than boron due to the larger size. Here ऐसा पूछा गया है कि what are the deviation, what you observe from this data. So we can see that aluminium has lower ionization enthalpy than that of boron due to the larger size. When we are moving towards the group, the atomic size increase, atomic radius increase. तो ये उसका reason है. दूसरा कि gallium, it is having a slightly higher ionization enthalpy than that of aluminium due to the Sylvian effect. Then third, when we talked about indium, Ion, that is not in, that is indium. Indium has lower ionization enthalpy than gallium due to large size. So you can see children over here, large size is very maximum and Sylvian effect is maximum. So you can write the answer in two lines that due to the larger size and due to the Sylvian effect, you can see the deviation. आप यहाँ पे ये डेटा पे लिख सकते हो कि due to the larger size as well. You can write that due to Sylvian effect or effective Sylvian effect in the core electrons, you can see the deviation along the group. Now question number 20 children. Which of the following pairs of the elements would have more negative electron gain enthalpy? Children, हमने देखा है when we are moving oxygen or fluorine. So when we talk about oxygen is equal to 8, fluorine is equal to 9. That means it is towards the along the period. So when we talked about oxygen, oxygen is smaller size than that of fluorine. So we can say that fluorine is having more electronegative gain enthalpy than that of oxygen due to the small size, higher nuclear charge and the it is very near to the normal basis. So three reason de sakte hain iske liye. First, oxygen has smaller size, large nuclear charge or high nuclear charge, and fluorine is very nearby the normal gas. You can write this. Aur pucha gaya hai fluorine and chlorine, that means now fluorine is equal to 9 and chlorine is equal to 17. ये along the period था, ये down the group है. तो यहाँ पे chlorine has more electronegative ionization and electron gain enthalpy than that of fluorine, because in whatever the incoming electron are there added, that is there now occupy large region of a space. So electron repulsion expand, and due to that we can say that when we are moving down the group, chlorine is become more electronegative, containing more electronegative gain enthalpy than that of fluorine. Oxygen or fluorine पूछा जाए तो हम लिखेंगे that fluorine has more electron gain enthalpy because oxygen has smaller size, high nuclear charge and fluorine is very near to the noble gas. Whereas when we cover fluorine and chlorine, the answer is fluorine, because when we are moving down the group, the fluorine electronegative character decreases and due to that chlorine has more electronegative gain enthalpy than that of fluorine. So that is about question number 20. Now next we will talk about 21. What do you expect the second electron gain enthalpy of oxygen as positive, more negative or less negative than the first? Justify your answer. तो हम देख सकते हैं कि जो भी ऑक्सीजन की सेकेंड आयनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी क्यों इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन एंथैल्पी है, क्योंकि ऑक्सीजन के पास 6 इलेक्ट्रॉन 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन है, दैट मींस कि इसके जो नेक्स्ट सेल है उसमें कितने इलेक्ट्रॉन है, 6. उसको नोबेल गैस स्टेबल बनने के लिए 2 मोर इलेक्ट्रॉन इट रिक्वायर. सो इट डज नॉट गेन द इलेक्ट्रॉन एट ए टाइम, सेम टाइम पे वो दोनों इलेक्ट्रॉन को गेन करेगा नहीं, सक्सेसिवली इट इज गोइंग टू एड अप द इलेक्ट्रॉन वन बाय वन. सो इट दैट्स व्हाई, दैट इज द रीजन that the first ionization enthalpy is negative, whereas second electron gain enthalpy is positive. So that means the energy supplied from the O minus 2 negative to O minus 2, in order to overcome the repulsive force, we can say that the second ion addition, second electron gain enthalpy of oxygen is positive. Now next one is we have to differentiate between electron gain enthalpy and electronegativity. Electron gain enthalpy, when you talk about, when your electron is added to the outermost shell, whatever the energy is required, that is known as electron gain enthalpy. Electronegativity is a qualitative measurement of the ability of the atom to attract the said electron in chemical compound. It is the definition first we have to write. It has absolute value, it does not have any measurable quantity. Its periodicity is not regular in a period or in a group, but its periodicity is regular in period but not regular in group. It means they are not specific in group. Here it is not specific in both of period as well as in group. Then unit of electron gain enthalpy is there in kilojoule per mole, or you can write that kilo calorie per mole. And here electronegativity has no unit to measure out. So that is about the question number 22. Now question number 23. How do you react to statement that electronegativity of nitrogen or folding scale is 3 in all the nitrogen compounds? So we can say that this statement given over here in the question is incorrect statement, because electronegativity is rise when we are moving down the group. So this is incorrect statement. Now next question number 24, children. You can see over here. Describe the theory associated with the radius of an atom as the electron is going to be gained and lost. So electron gain enthalpy, the gain of the electron leads to the formation of anion, or we can say that negatively charged ion. So whenever we are finding out the radius of the anion, it is larger than the atomic radius of its parent atom, because when you are one or more than one electrons are going to be added, due to that the repulsive force is going to be increased and the nuclear charge is going to be decreased, and that is the reason that electron is held less likely, and due to that electron cloud expand. So that is the one particular theory associated with the radius that it is going to be decreased. Now next one is, whenever the electrons are going to be removed from the atom, they are forming the positively charged ion, or we can say that cation. And when you talk about cation, it is having a smaller size than that of parent atom, because electrons are now going to be removed from that particular shell or the orbit. So we can say that here, whatever the radius is there, very small, here very large. So this is the particular, we can say that explanation of question number 24. Now last question, question number 25. Would you expect the first ionization enthalpy for two isotopes of the same element to be the same or different? दो आइसोटोप है, अगर किसी के भी कार्बन के दो आइसोटोप है, कार्बन 14, कार्बन 12, कार्बन 13, तो हम उसकी आयनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी के बारे में क्या बोलेंगे? सो हियर व्हेन यू बी टॉक अबाउट, हियर द एग्जांपल ऑफ क्लोरीन इज टेकन, क्लोरीन विद 17 एटम्स नंबर एंड 35 एटॉमिक मास एंड 17 एंड 37 एटॉमिक मास. सो हियर व्हेन यू टॉक अबाउट द आइसोटोप्स ऑफ द क्लोरीन, ड्यू टू द सेम इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज, देयर इज नो चेंज इन द first ionization enthalpy. So that is the reason. Now we have to write about the differentiate between metals and non-metals. Already we have learned in 9th class, 8th class, so you can write by yourself. So there is no need to be discussed. Now next is, कौन सा ऐसा element है जिसके outermost shell में 5 electrons subshells है? Identify an element with 5 electrons in the outermost shell. So we are writing that is fluorine. Periodic table. Identify an element that would tend to lose 2 electrons, that is magnesium. Identify an element that tend to gain 2 electrons, that is oxygen. See, we can write the answer that fluorine, when we talked about 1s2, 2s2, to be 5. So ये 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन हो गए ना मैग्नीशियम, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, तो दैट हैज टेंडेंसी टू लूज 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. oxygen 1s2 2s2 2p2, that means now we are going to talk about 2p4. So it has tendency to gain 2 electrons and identify the group having metal, non-metal, liquid as well as gas at the temperature. So that are the group number 17 elements. Fluorine and chlorine, they are in the form of gas. Bromine is in the form of liquid, and iodine, that is there in the mantle clusteris form. So that is about question number 27. So this is all about today. In the next lecture, we are starting with question number 28, solution of question number 28. And then we are starting with chapter number 9, children. Your midterm syllabus is chapter number 1, chapter number 2, chapter number 3 and chapter number 9 half. Whatever the portion of the chapter number 9 is going to be covered, that is your syllabus for the midterm. Thank you and have a nice day.